stay up here. System status check. Everything's looking good. Ready to take her down.
Roger.
Flight plan calls for turn to heading 120. Please don't make me puke my guts out.
I'll do my best. Turning to 120. Gray Eagle, this is Black Star 2.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle. Go ahead.
Gray Eagle, I'm requesting clearance to Beale.
Roger, Black Star. We have radar contact on you. You're cleared as file to Beale, direct Las Vegas. Jet 110 to Clovis, direct. Descend and maintain flight level 520.
The hell are you doing back there?
Jesus Christ, everything is full of static electricity.
That's strange. I've got some static, but not more than usual. You got a problem?
No, I just look like a troll doll.
Approaching start point. What's our TOT?
Time over target is 0700.
Okay. Going down.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle. We show you descending through 480. Do you concur?
Okay, Tommy, here we go. Mission checklist. EFIS and pilot's aid emergency battery.
EFIS and backup power on.
Static interference computers.
Static interference computers armed.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle. We show you descending through 390. You have traffic 8 o'clock, 12 miles northeastbound at 370. Do you read?
Tommy?
I see him. We've got plenty of room.
Radar deflection shield switch in unguarded position.
Roger. Radar shield switch in unguarded position. Present altitude 320. 310290.
They're gonna have a shit fit any minute.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle. We show you going through 250. Do you read?
Duran following radar switch on.
TFR on.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle on guard. Ident if you read.
Cloaking switch in unguarded position.
Roger. Cloaking switch in unguarded position.
Arm all systems.
Roger. All systems armed.
Gray Eagle, Denver Center on guard.
Roger, Denver Center.
We've lost Black Star 2. Do you have them?
Denver Center? We seem to have lost radar contact with Black Star also.
And they were never seen or heard from again. Tommy, turn off Gray Eagle and go secure on Channel 3.
Turning off Gray Eagle.
Black Star 2, this is Gray Eagle.
You're scrambled on Channel 3.
Black Magic to Operation Overcoat. Commencing scrambled transmission.
Overcoat to Black Magic, we read you loud and clear. Standing by for flight status.
Stealth system control checklist.
Roger. Stealth system control checklist complete.
Tommy, now it's gone. Black Magic to Overcoat. Stealth mission commenced at 1-2000.
Roger. Going to HUD failure checklist matrix. Confirm that your HUD switch is in the on position.
Roger. It's in on position. Still don't have it.
Roger. Recycling HUD switch.
Still nothing. Black Magic to Overcoat, mission time 0708. How do we look?
We hear you, but we definitely don't see you.
Roger, Overcoat. Tommy, how are we coming?
I'm still trying. Hang on.
Hello. Hunt's back.
Roger. Stealth system nominal.
Black Magic, we've got some good news. Based on Gray Eagle and Denver Center, it's safe to assume you're completely off the scope as advertised. Looks like we've suckered out Don Air Force.
Roger, Overcoat. Hey, you back there.
Hold on.
It works. The son of a bitch really works.
Black Magic, give us a system status check.
Roger. Tommy?
Everything's green.
Overcoat, everything's green. Except Thompson's got some static cling in his underwear.
Do you mind not discussing my lingerie over the air?
Roger, Black Magic. You have a low pressure front building up at your 11 o'clock. You may be experiencing some pre-lightning static activity.
I don't see anything. Looks like 12 miles visibility. And the clouds we've got don't look like the kind that lightning leaps out.
Holy shit!
Whoa, Nelly.
Tommy, you want to give me a status check?
So much for your lightning theory, Einstein.
Any damage?
Everything looks okay, but that doesn't mean it works.
Overcoat, I think we've been hit by lightning. We're pretty sure it was a strike. Running a systems check.
Black Magic, we have a line fail in your telemetric flight transponder. We are switching you to auxiliary.
Roger, Overcoat.
Black Magic, be read.
Roger, Overcoat.
Black Magic, this is Operation Overcoat. We have a line fail in your telemetric transponder. Do you read?
Great.
Going to number two radio. Try it again.
Overcoat, this is Black Magic. Do you read?
I show at least three system failures, and we've got a fuel line leak in number two. Running a diagnostic.
Fire.
We've got a fire in number two. Tommy?
Roger. Fire extinguisher bottle for number two engine.
Number two selected.
Fire handle pull.
I'm starting to lose thrust in number two. It's going through 80%.
Looks like possible computer damage.
Tommy, I'm dumping aft fuel.
Roger on aft fuel. I still show a fire warning on number two.
Gray Eagle, this is Black Star 2. We have an engine fire.
Running an engine fire checklist.
Gray Eagle, this is Black Star 2. We obviously have a major malfunction here.
Dump complete.
Tommy, I'm going to try and get us down on one of these flats, lowering gear.
Auto eject system is now.
We've got an eject message.
Auto eject system.
Roger.
I'm going to engine checkdown. Can you move the throttle?
System is now
Roger.
Auto eject system armed. Auto eject system active. Auto eject
Gray Eagle, this is Black Star 2. Do you
auto
read?
Auto eject system active. Auto eject system active. Auto eject system active.
This thing's gonna spit us out of here unless you can
auto
put us down.
I see a clearing. I can get us
auto
down. I can get us down. Reducing thrust.
We're too low.
Pulling up gear! Pulling up gear!
Oh my god.
System abort. System abort. System abort. System abort. System abort. System
Halsey? Dr. Gottlieb will see you now.
Is she talking to me? She's got to be talking to me. There's nobody else in here.
Nice, huh?
Who the heck is this?
I call it heaven and hell. I kind of see it as the ultimate Rorschach test, you know what I mean? What do you think?
Well, it catches your eye.
A diplomat, good answer. I painted it. Go ahead, Jason, make yourself comfortable. Come.
Jason.
How do I know? I know you're here somewhere.
Not the couch.
Here we are.
You'll think you're nuts. A chair. Take the chair.
Go ahead, Jason. Colonel, you okay?
Sure, fine. I'm fine.
Good.
Colonel. Don't panic. It's all gonna make sense any minute now.
So what would you like to talk about?
Well, frankly, I don't even know what I'm doing here. I mean, I know what I'm doing here, but...
Jason, relax. Tell me anything. What did you have for breakfast this morning?
This morning? Breakfast this morning? This is ridiculous.
That's okay. Forget it. Something else. What about last night? Did you sleep well last night?
Last night. Sleep, bed, mattress, sleep, pillow, last night.
That's okay. All right. I'll tell you what. Sometimes I find that it's a good idea to start way back. Childhood, that kind of stuff.
I can't remember what happened 15 minutes ago. And he wants to know about my childhood?
Jason.
Hmm?
Did you hear me?
Yes. Yes. My recollection is a bit vague.
Well, you must remember something. There must have been some significant moments in your life.
Well, I can't say that I remember any.
I see. All right. Let's try something else. No, sit. Let's try something else here. It's a word association game. I'm sure you remember playing something like it when you were a kid. I say a word, you say the first thing that comes to your mind. First thing, don't think too much about it, all right?
Okay.
Right. Life.
Death.
Apple.
Eve.
Woman.
Man.
Love.
Pain.
Sex.
Pleasure.
Dream.
Nightmare.
Airplane.
Black?
Mad.
Hatter.
Insane.
Psychiatrist?
Tree.
Oh my.
brain.
Damage.
Reality.
Fantasy.
Home.
Sky.
Fast.
Faster.
Crash.
Accident.
Lightning.
Flash.
Short.
Circuit.
Black.
Invisible.
Test.
Flight.
Rock.
Sharp.
Impact.
Collision.
Memory.
Flashback.
Infinity.
Endless.
Mind.
Maze.
Phantom.
Transparent.
Clear.
Obscure.
Door.
Passage.
God.
Death.
So, what do you think? Anything?
This is crazy. No?
Anything come to mind? Anything you want to talk about? Nothing at all.
Think logically. There's got to be some rational explanation.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. Okay, okay. 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 All I want you to do is look at these patterns. Right? Five in color, five in black and white. I want you to tell me what you think they could be. Quick first impression. All right?
Rational explanation. Let's see. I don't know who I am. I don't know who he is. I don't...
This one?
Well... looks like a squashed bat.
Squashed bat. Very well.
Can I turn this thing?
You can do anything you want with it.
Tree with branches and
you all understand this is a highly sensitive mission.
Tree with branches, and?
Nothing, just a tree.
Right. This one?
This one?
Mm-hmm.
This one?
Yeah.
Looks a lot like your painting.
You're right, that's amazing. I never noticed that. All right, I'll be done.
This looks like a cross section of a...
Trust you. you understand, you are no ordinary classified operational team.
What the hell is happening to me?
Are you all right?
It's a brain. Looks like a cross-section of a brain. Well, that's a fried egg.
An egg?
Yeah, it's a fried egg. It's like it's splattered in a frying pan.
An egg.
This is ludicrous.
Right.
This is some kind of geometric shape.
Mm-hmm. This pen.
Okay, let's see. I could be stark raving mad. No, I don't like that one.
So what kind of geometric shape? This pen?
I don't know. It just looks like a geometric shape of a blade or a propeller.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Maybe it's amnesia. But why hasn't he brought that up?
Okay, all right.
Listen, I'm not quite sure how to say this, but I don't know what I'm doing here, and I don't know.
Operation Black Magic will bypass traditional Air Force protocol and standard operational channels. This project and its missions are considered very black. Any related intelligence is being disclosed on a need-to-know basis only. Consider yourselves privileged, gentlemen. Your own commander-in-chief doesn't know this much. 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 Doesn't know this much.
Holy shit.
You were saying?
It's a plane.
What's a plane?
It's a plane. It's a plane.
A plane, an airplane?
Yeah, a plane. It's the front view of an aircraft.
Now, I think we're making some headway here. All right, now you were saying a second ago.
Oh, I was going to say that I don't know where we're going with all of this.
I'm terribly sorry. I'm sure I have another refill for this pen somewhere. I'll be with you in a moment. I know it's here someplace.
This is bullshit.
I thought you said it was a plane.
Not the card. This session, you, this office is bullshit.
I knew there was another one in here somewhere. Okay, now, why do you think this?
Well, for starters, I haven't got a clue how I got here.
Go on.
I mean, I'm sure I never met you. I am positive of that. I don't know who the fuck you are. Nothing that we've discussed here makes any sense to me at all. In fact, I don't know who the fuck I am.
So what's your point?
You see what I mean? What kind of an asshole answer is that?
I'm sorry.
You are not sorry. Believe me, you're not sorry. That is more bullshit. You're just toying with me like I'm some demented idiot. Well, I want to tell you something. I am not a demented idiot. It's a dream. This whole damn thing is nothing more than a dream.
A dream?
Yeah. A dream! A dream! What, I got an echo in here? It's a dream!
Like a nightmare.
Like a nightmare.
So none of this is really happening.
Right.
This is all an hallucination.
Absolutely.
I see. And you felt this the moment you walked in?
The ashtray. It started with the ashtray.
The ashtray?
Yeah. I mean, there I was, staring at a face that I didn't even recognize. I walk in here, and you act as if you know who I am.
You were staring at the ashtray? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to throw you off.
Oh, shit. What the hell was I saying?
You figured this was all a dream.
Oh, God. I want to know what's going through my head.
So do I.
You want to know what's going through my head? I'm going to show you what's going through my head. This whole room, this stupid conversation is nothing but a figment of my imagination.
Like a delusion, a mirage.
You think if any of this were real, you'd let me do this? That? Or this? Or this? Huh? Or this? I'll take this. How about this? Ah! Let me do this, or this, or this, or this. You don't even fucking exist.
Sounds like you're angry.
Oh. With what? An illusion?
Don't ever touch. So what do you think we should do about this situation? I mean, in view of the fact that you feel it's a dream.
I don't have to do anything. I'm going to wake up any minute.
All right. I see. Well, shall we wait together?
You do what you want. I'm out of here.
All right. Well, until you wake up, can we keep on talking?
Attention to detail. You're so real, it's spooky.
I'll bet.
You know, I didn't even want to sit on the couch before. You know, I thought you'd think I was nuts.
Is that right?
Oh, it's amazing what the human mind can do, huh?
No kidding.
Just close your eyes. That's it. Just relax. No point in fighting it.
Jason?
Oh, go away.
Don't you think this is getting a bit silly, Jason?
Absolutely. So just leave me alone.
Jason? Come on now. This is ridiculous. Now, Jason, this is getting crazy.
It's a dream. It's a dream.
update package you boys are going to be dealing with consists of a total skin replacement, a non-reflective composite coating, and the CST IPEX wave diffuser. Now, this is obviously a stopgap measure, but I can assure you, with the onboard static interference computers, this baby will confuse the shit out of any radar system without having to build a new plane from scratch. No one can know about this. You understand? No one.
Jeff, what are you doing here?
Halsey, this technology goes way beyond cutting edge. We're not talking titanium fuselages. These damn birds are made out of plastic. Plastic!
General, could I ask you something? Could you help me get out of this nightmare?
Sure, in a sec. Do you realize what this means? We're talking stealth without anyone knowing about it. Everybody's attention is on the B-2 and the new fighter, which stick out like sore thumbs. But if this update package works, we could modify our existing birds while everyone's staring at flying boomerangs.
General, I have a much bigger problem.
What's really great about it is they'll almost look the same. Regular planes with invisible paint. Get it? So they'll be black. So we'll cook up some cock and bull story why they have to look a little different. But if this IPEX package really works, who gives a shit? Do you realize the potential we've got here?
Hello? Anybody in there?
Halsey, you cannot discuss this with anyone, regardless of rank. I don't care if it's the Secretary of Defense. You understand?
Help me. Help me, for Christ's sakes.
You've got a lot on your mind.
But while you're waiting to wake up, why don't you come in and help me straighten this out? Hmm? Come on, now, after all, this is your mess. Come on, Dad, grab some of these books.
God. It can't be. Can't be. It's too insane.
Jason, now, come on. Now, what's fair is fair.
Am I nuts? Tell me the truth. Am I nuts?
You're asking me, it's your dream.
Oh, don't screw with me. Give it to me straight. Am I nuts?
Well, why don't we talk about it?
Oh, shit.
Now, look, I didn't say you were nuts.
Oh, I see. Well, the lobotomy was a success.
You know, craziness is a relative concept.
Oh, God, please.
Well, think about it. Do you know the difference between a madman and a genius?
It's another test.
I'm serious. There's a very fine line between the two. You see, a genius uses his madness constructively, and a madman uses his genius destructively. Think of that. No, wait. A genius uses his madness constructively, and, a madman uses his genius destructively and...
What the fuck are you talking about? What the fuck are you talking about? My mind is potato puree. You're giving me platitudes.
Jason, we're gonna get through this together. That's what I'm here for. I know you're confused. It's okay.
It's not okay. It's horrible. It's the worst feeling I've ever had.
Come on, sweet. Sit down and relax. Come on. Sit down. Relax. Just take a deep breath, all right? That's it. It all seemed better. That's it. I'll be right back. Let's discuss some of the impressions you had. Have an apple.
Oh, I can't eat.
All right. In case you change your mind. All right. you tell me about that? Anything in particular?
A tree. A tree. I used to play on one when I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was huge. Had a swing on it. Basically, it was an old rope with a big tractor tire.
Mm-hmm. Jason! Please be careful on that swing!
I had this thing about touching the sky. My mother would get hysterical because I would swing back and forth like a wild monkey trying to get higher and higher.
And?
And I had this little accident. I must have been 9 or 10.
You fell off.
I smashed into the tree head on, scared the crap out of my parents.
So why do you think you wanted to touch the sky?
Oh, I guess I always had this fascination with height and speed.
Speed?
Yeah. Wanting to control it. I always wanted to touch the outer limits.
At 9?
Well, I don't know. I guess I just wanted to be free to get away.
From what?
I'm not quite sure.
What do you think?
I don't know.
All right. Cross section of a brain, correct?
Good news, folks. Jason's going to be fine.
Oh, thank God.
Skull x-rays show no fractures. It doesn't look like there's a subdural hematoma or any other pressure on the brain.
No brain damage? He was twitching something awful, you know.
He was shaking pretty terribly, Doctor.
He may have experienced a seizure. That would explain the convulsions. But I don't think there's anything to worry about. I'm doing a series of EEGs just to be on the safe side. I'm also bringing in Dr. Brookman. He's our neurologist.
Why do we need another doctor?
Well, there's a very remote, and I mean remote, possibility that Jason could experience recurring seizures down the line.
It reminded you of a brain.
Shit. They're back.
Right?
Did I... Mention what happened to me after the accident?
With the tree?
I had some kind of head injury.
A head injury?
Yeah. Well, not really. I mean, I had some sort of
seizures?
Well, I'm not sure. Maybe something like them.
When was this?
For a few years as a kid.
Well, can you remember anything about them?
I didn't tell anyone.
Why not?
I had some pretty strange experiences. I thought they'd think I was out of my mind.
I see. So your parents didn't know?
No, nobody knew. I didn't even know. I mean, I've had these weird flashes out of nowhere, all jumbled together. Weird stuff. And they come and go just like that.
Mm-hmm. Any smells?
Yeah. Strange things. Burnt rubber, skunk. Glue.
Mm-hmm. Yep, sounds like seizures to me.
Yes. The brain is fascinating. Did you know that it's made of tissue that can develop an electrical charge? Hitting your head like you did, you probably ended up with some pretty serious post-concussive trauma. You might have had a brain cell in the wrong place or enervated in some weird way. Maybe you're getting the wrong type of signals or
weren't that bad.
Primary and secondary seizures. All right. Primary seizures seem to be the result of some, biochemical or genetic screw-up, while secondary seizures result from some pathologic condition or disease. Now, from what you're telling me, it sounds like you may have had some intracranial damage to the old cabeza. You may have had a seizure right after the accident, or several months or years later. Who knows?
Well, they were nothing, really.
What do you consider nothing?
Well, we're not talking about your normal garden variety falling on the floor, writhing around seizures here.
You mean they weren't grand mal seizures?
Well, I don't know what the technical term is.
Like that. Anything close? Have you ever seen that kind of attack?
Oh, my God. No. Oh, I was more of an internal kind of thing. You wouldn't even know I was having
petite mal seizures.
Petite mal?
Yes. See, you still would have lost awareness, maybe 5 or 10 seconds, but all you'd have is a blank stare. Maybe some mild eye twitching, perhaps some lip smacking, and loss of motor activity.
This guy's a nutcase. Neat. That's fascinating.
Yes. But you specifically said something about weird flashes, hallucinations, strange smells and sounds. Now, the only seizures that have those symptoms are simple or complex partial seizures.
So which is it?
Which is what?
Of the two choices.
Choice?
The kinds of seizures.
Oh, complex partial seizures could be simple partial seizures because you would have been jerking uncontrollably, grimacing, sweating, that sort of thing. You didn't have that, did you?
No, I don't think so.
No, I didn't think so either. All right. Where were we? Here we have a geometric shape, a blade, propeller.
Something burning?
Hey, Jace. I hear your not-so-secret plastic planes make great lightning rods. Lightning rods.
Crash.
Excuse me? I thought you said propeller.
Huh? Oh. Right.
You just said crash.
Right.
And something about burning.
Oil. I smelled burning engine oil. Like that race car smell.
He knows. He knows I'm having them. Maybe this time I've got brain damage.
I try to think what first came to mind when you thought you saw a propeller.
Flying, I think.
So you saw a plane?
I guess.
What about the crash?
I don't,
That's right, that's fine. That's fine, that's fine. let's go back to this flying thing for a moment, all right? You think this may have anything to do with your wanting to touch the sky? You still have this feeling?
I guess. I think it was more pronounced after the accident.
How's that?
Well, I don't know. I suppose I had a greater sense of control, of freedom, being stronger.
Stronger than anyone who didn't have seizures?
No. I wanted to fly way before I had any seizures.
Oh, I see. Well, did you ever actually fly?
Oh, God, yes, even before I had a driver's license. As a matter of fact, when I stopped having seizures.
I did stop having them.
When was that?
I'm not exactly sure. I must have been 15, 16 years old. They were less and less frequent, and eventually I never even thought of them.
Mm-hmm. Go on.
Well, then I really went crazy.
Bad choice.
Well, not crazy, nuts. I mean, just crazy. Yeah, you know, wild, like a teenage kind of stuff.
Oh. Go on.
Well, I did everything. Mm-hmm. Anything that had to do with going faster, higher, further, anything that had to do with compressing time, anything that, you know, was a little dangerous or was...
Death-defying?
Oh, well, I don't know about death-defying.
Well, what did you mean by compressing time?
Well, I had this thing about dying young. Now, I really don't know why, but I guess I just wanted to live more. I wanted to squeeze more life into the time that I had. And I think I was scared shitless that I wouldn't have a chance to do everything that I had to do or wanted to do or whatever.
So how do you feel about death now? I mean, are you still afraid of dying?
I haven't given it much thought recently.
Think about it ever?
Well, I try to avoid that line of thought.
Why?
I'm not ready now. Maybe when I'm older.
Trust me, no one's ever ready. But that's right. You were saying teenage.
Oh yeah. Well, I really got into the typical teenage stuff. Cars. Motorcycles, airplanes, anything, you know. The usual stupid thing of souping them up and pushing them too hard.
Go on.
I got an old P-51.
P-51?
19, I think. I think I was 19. I rebuilt it with Doug.
Doug?
Yeah. Doug Schlesinger is my best friend. We went in on it together.
Now, this P-51 is a plane, I assume.
It's the closest thing to having wings.
How did it feel up there?
Indescribable.
So tell me about Doug. Your friend, Doug.
Come on.
We lost his BP.
Get a Foley in him and get me some blood type for Cross, and let's get a stat crit.
I'm gonna get Nichols and radiology down here now. I need a portable skull and
come
chest.
Come on, people, let's hustle. We're losing him. Alert OR3.
What do you have?
Got a Cross.
car crash. 20-year-old white male. CHP said he tried to move a rock wall to me in 90.
Dr. Stahl and Dr. G to psychiatrist.
Hey, look what I brought
Dr.
you. It's our baby. Look at the detail on this sucker.
Dr. Gottlieb to receiving. Dr. Gottlieb to receiving.
I hit my head again. That's got to be it.
Okay.
This may not matter now, but I remember something about the crash.
Which crash?
The crash I mentioned before.
All right, right, right.
I had a car accident.
I see. All right.
Maybe I'm both insane and suffering from amnesia.
Last one.
It can't be total amnesia. I do remember some things. I remember the accident. I couldn't be inventing that. I know how to fly. Think. God damn it. Pre-flight checklist, fuel comp, anti-skid, jet pumps, ground idle on, emergency pressure override.
P-51.
No, SR-71. SR-71 photo reconnaissance. U-2 aircraft. It's,
Spy plane.
Well, no, it looks like a cross between an SR and a stealth plane. A radar-invisible son of U-2. Francis Gary Powers. He flew over the Soviet Union in a U-2. Was shot down.
This Mr. Powers was a friend of yours?
Where have you been, Francis Gary Powers? He was the biggest Cold War story of 1960. Eisenhower, Khrushchev.
Of course, of course. Now, how does the SR-71 fit in all this?
Well, it came after you, too. For photo surveillance, top secret stuff.
I see. So why do you think you know so much about it?
Me.
I'm so scared.
I know.
I don't want to die.
Don't talk that way.
I just want to love you.
We don't even know it's cancer.
I love you not only for what you've made of yourself, but for what you are making of me.
This ring is a symbol of my undying love.
This ring is a symbol of my undying love.
By the power vested in me, I pronounce you husband and wife.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Can I get you something?
No, I'm okay.
Sure.
Okay.
A glass of water.
Yeah. Here we go.
hurt.
Rock.
I never will.
Jason, cut it out.
She's gone, Jason.
So why do you think you know so much about planes?
I'm a pilot. I've flown since I was a kid.
What kind of pilot?
I'm not sure.
I see. Think.
Live with her memory anymore. It's destroying you, it's killing our marriage, and you're taking me down with it. She's gone, Jason. She's gone.
Jason?
I don't know. I don't really remember, really. I'm sorry.
That's okay, that's okay. Are you sure you're all right? You look kind of peaked.
No, I'm fine. Huh? I'm fine. I'm fine.
The whole thing has become an obsession. Can't you see? It's sick.
I love you.
You also love your dead wife. She's gone.
Huh. Casey. My wife. Casey.
Tell me.
Brooke. Brooke!
Who's Brooke?
She's gone, Jason. I know you still think of her. Think of her. In the back of your head, you still think of her. In the back of your head.
In the back of your head.
No one can know about
it. Oh, Jace, this is getting kind of crazy. Even the utility guys know more about it than I do. What the hell are you guys working on? What are you doing?
You can tell me.
These damn birds are made out of plastic. Plastic?
You know I'm crazy about you, don't you?
We're talking stealth.
You've got to stop denying you have secrets, Jason. That's just crazy.
Total skin replacement.
You've got to tell the truth.
Composite coating.
Tell us the truth, Jason.
Hey.
You've got to stop denying you have secrets, Jason. Tell us the truth, Jason.
Hey.
We're talking stealth, without anyone knowing.
I'm your best friend, but I have to agree with Casey and Brooke. This is pretty crazy.
Without anyone knowing.
You've got to tell me the truth. Tell us the truth. Come on, you can tell me.
Leave your name and a brief message after the seizure.
You know I'm crazy about you, don't you? Crazy.
I'm just
crazy.
Yep, crazy.
Crazy.
You're crazy.
No, not crazy.
You're crazy.
No, I'm crazy.
Hallucinations. Jesus, I came out of hallucinations. My parents, you, Brooke.
Brooke?
Oh, God. Chuck Geller was still alive.
General Geller?
Yeah. There he was. Badgering me.
It's okay. It's okay. It's over now. I'm here. Okay.
I'm
going to
run through a nice hot bath. You're going to feel better. Give me that.
Everything's fine now. Everything's okay.
Yep.
You know why this happened, don't you?
Why?
That damn chili of yours at 10 o'clock at night.
It had nothing to do with chili.
Rinse.
I have never, ever experienced anything like it. Trust me.
Honey, we have that.
I kept seeing pieces of my life, you know, just flying by.
How's that?
It was horrible. It was you and Doug were, and you were laughing and saying that I was crazy, and there was this lunatic standing there eating an apple.
That's right, Jane. I'll get your tea. You rinse off.
Okay.
You got one thing right in your dream.
What's that?
You are a tad crazy. But I love you anyway. Which may lose consciousness and the simple partial seizures where there is no loss of consciousness at all. So we're out of the area of the That's right. Simple partial seizures.
Jason, easy. You just had a grand mal seizure, and you had us worried there for a while. Easy, easy.
No.
All right, you're gonna be fine. You're gonna be fine. How's your tongue? Okay. All right. You're gonna have a slight headache and some soreness, but that's normal. That's all right, Miss Peters. I'll take it now. Thank you. Yeah, that's fine. It's fine. Thank you. Easy, easy. Now, do you remember having seizures like this when you were a child?
No.
What about as an adult?
I don't know. Just leave me alone.
All right, just breathe. Breathe deeply. Breathe. Come on now. Just take it easy. That's it. Breathe deeply. That's better. Just breathe. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Come on, focus on your breathing. Okay. Just let your body go. Focus, breathing. That's it. Just concentrate on your breathing. Come on, concentrate on your breathing. That's it. That's good.
Come on.
Pick something in the room and focus. Focus. Focus on it. That's it. Clear your mind. Pick anything and focus on it. Don't take your eyes off of it. Come on, try now. For me now. You can do it. That's it. Clear your mind.
No.
Come on, breathe.
No.
In, out. Good. Just feel the air moving in and out of your lungs. Come on, Colonel. You can do it. You can. That's better. That's much better. everything. Concentrate now. Pick something up. Come on, right there. Come on, right there. That's it. That's it. Block out everything except the sound of the air and my voice. That's good. You're in the cockpit of a plane. Concentrate. Try and remember. I want you to think back, Jason. Think about flying.
Air Force. Air Force.
Remember what you did in the Air Force.
I touched the sky.
Why do you touch the sky, Jason?
Flying experimental.
Flying experimental what?
Plastic planes.
What about plastic planes?
Radar transparent. Almost invisible.
So?
Vulnerable. Vulnerable to lightning. Damaged flight electronics could cause plane to crash.
Can you remember what you did?
I don't remember.
Were there other missions?
Black. I remember black. Black missions. Black spark. Black magic. Test spark.
What is black magic? What is spark?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Think, Jason. You must remember.
Secret.
Secret.
Modified planes. Not used anymore.
What do you mean by modified?
The skin. Radar deflection. New structure. Old planes brought back into service.
Old?
Retired. Retired planes with new shell. Brought back for Geller.
No one can know about this. You understand? No one.
Who is Geller?
Geller is black magic.
What is black magic? What is spark?
Halsey, you cannot discuss this with anyone. Regardless of rank, I don't care if it's the Secretary of Defense. You understand?
What is black magic? What is spark?
Lightning proof. Stealth. Lightning protected.
What did you do with black magic? What happened to spark?
I'm not sure.
What is black magic?
I don't know. I'm confused. Just leave me alone. I don't know.
You can remember, Jason.
No, I can't remember.
Yes, you can. What's more?
These damn birds are made out of plastic. Plastic.
You can't tell him. Don't tell him. I don't remember.
Think, Colonel Halsey. Think. Your mission. What is your mission?
Albuquerque. Albuquerque, Tonopah.
New Mexico? What's Tonopah?
Nevada. Tonopah.
What's in Tonopah?
Stealth. Stealth tests.
After start engine checklist complete.
Roger. Taxi checklist.
Roger. Commencing taxi checklist.
Albuquerque Tower, this is Black Star 2, requesting clearance to Beale.
Taxi checklist complete.
Roger, Black Star 2, you are cleared to Beale via direct Farmington as final.
Roger, Albuquerque Tower. Black Star 2 taxiing. Ready to approach east-west runway 27.
Roger, Black Star 2, you are cleared for taxiing to runway 27.
Taxi lights on.
Roger, Black Star 2, you are clear for takeoff.
Black Star 2 is rolling. Albuquerque Roger, this is Blackstar 2.
Roger, Blackstar 2. Go ahead.
We're outbound, heading 089er.
109.9, switched.
Blackstar 2, you're cleared to BOV to direct. Farmington is filed. Contact Gray Eagle 234.2, Squawk 1047. They'll pick you up after Farmington.
What is black magic?
I don't know.
What is black magic? Jason, what is it? What does it mean?
I don't remember black magic.
I know you remember, Jason. You remember everything you've ever experienced, everything you've seen, heard, tasted, smelled, felt, is stored in your brain. Everything.
Why does he want to know about black magic? No one knows about black magic. No one knows about black magic. No one knows about black magic. Why is he doing this? Why?
Doing a system status check. Okay. Level off check is complete.
Roger. Ready for afterburner check.
Albuquerque Center afterburner test complete. We show everything green.
Roger, Blackstar 2.
Initiating climb checklist.
Roger.
Everything's a go.
Roger. Adding power for climb.
Flight navigation route check complete.
Roger.
Level off checklist complete.
Roger. Leveling off at 80,000.
Switching off radios.
Looks beautiful. God, sometimes I wish I could stay up here.
System status check. Everything's looking good. Ready to take her down.
Roger.
This project and its missions are considered.
Flight plan calls for turn to heading 120. Please don't make me puke my guts out.
I'll do my best. Turning to 120.
Gray Eagle, this is Blackstar 2. Blackstar 2, this is Gray Eagle. Go ahead.
Gray Eagle, I'm requesting clearance to Beale.
Roger, Blackstar. We have radar contact on you. Your clearance is filed to Beale, direct Las Vegas. Jet 110 to Clovis, direct. Descend and maintain flight level 520.
What are you doing back there?
Christ, everything is full of static electricity.
Going down.
Blackstar 2, this is Gray Eagle. We show you descending through 480. Do you concur?
Okay, Tommy, here we go. Mission checklist. EFIS and Pilot's Aid emergency battery.
EFIS and backup power on.
Static interference computers.
Static interference computers armed.
Blackstar 2, this is Gray Eagle. We show you descending through 390. You have traffic 8 o'clock, 12 miles northeastbound at 370. Do you read?
Tommy?
I see him. We've got plenty of room.
Radar deflection shield switch in unguarded position.
Roger. Radar shield switch in unguarded position. Present altitude 320. 3102.
Blackstar 2, this is Gray Eagle on guard. Ident if you read.
Cloaking switch in unguarded position.
Roger.
Gray Eagle, this is Denver Center on guard.
Roger, Denver Center.
All systems armed.
We've lost Blackstar 2. Do you have them?
were never seen or heard from again. Tommy, turn off Gray Eagle and go see. Stealth mission commenced at 1-2000. Roger, switching radar to weather mode. I don't see anything. Looks like 12 miles visibility, and the clouds we've got don't look like the kind lightning leaps out of.
Oh, shit!
We've got a fire in number two. Tommy?
Roger. Fire extinguisher bottle to number two engine.
This is Black Star 2. We have an engine fire.
We've got an eject message.
No one.
Auto eject system activated.
No one.
I see a clearing.
System armed.
No one.
System, I can get us down.
Abort. You understand?
System.
No one can.
Pulling
know.
Up gear. Pulling up gear.
No one.
Oh my God.
Jason? Jason? Jason?
You fucking son of a bitch.
No!
My head, you bastard! What's that?
You've had all along, haven't you, you bastard? What are you doing? Is this some form of brainwashing? What do you want? What do you people want from me? Huh?
Look, Jason. Come on. Let me go. Come on. No, don't.
What are you, Chinese, huh? Russian, Libyan? Who do you work for?
Don't be an idiot. I don't work for any government.
Who then?
If you calm down, we can talk about it.
Where the fuck am I? I want some fucking answers.
Are you quite finished? Are you? Why'd you sit down?
Well, you're not gonna get shit from me. You understand? Except name, rank, and serial number, and you can shove that up your ass.
If you just sit down, we can talk about anything you want.
Well, you sit down, you shithead. Don't tell me to sit down.
I haven't injected you with any drugs, and I couldn't care less about your silly phantom plane. I'm just trying to help you reconstruct your past.
Yeah, you guys froze me, didn't you?
I don't follow.
Suspended animation, cryogenics. That's why I look so old.
Cryogenics? Jason, this has nothing to do with suspended animation, or psychological warfare, or brainwashing, or planes, or stealth, schmelf!
Well, what in God's name is left? What does it have to do with?
Are you hungry?
What?
All this commotion has made me hungry. Come on, let's have a bite. Come on. Come on.
I don't believe it.
Come on. We'll sit. We'll talk. We'll have a little nosh.
I don't fucking believe it.
Red or white? Come on, Jason. Come on now. Sit down. It's time to have a little heart to heart. Come on. That's it.
This is unbelievable.
Good stuff.
It just isn't fair.
What isn't?
This madness. Oh, look at me. What's left of my life? What's happening to me?
Hembear?
Please, leave me alone.
I mean, when you say fair, conceptually, what are we talking about here? Good winning over evil? Righteousness triumphing over injustice? Clean living leads to good health, that sort of thing?
What do you people want from me?
Oh, just trying to Aren't you going to handle where your head is at, huh? With this life and fairness thing.
You're not nuts. You're not nuts. You know you're not nuts. You can't be nuts.
I mean, you can't possibly think that life is fair. Hmm? What about cancer? What about famine? Hitler? Earthquakes? Fair. Come on.
Don't listen to him. Don't listen.
Come on, sit. 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 Eat a little bit. You look tired. Come on. This has nothing to do with fairness, good or bad, right or wrong. It just is. So. All right. All right. Do you believe in God?
Don't listen to him. Just don't listen.
Jason?
Huh?
I asked you a question.
What?
Do you believe in God?
I don't know what I believe in anymore. If he exists, he's certainly forgotten about me.
Don't you think that's rather childish?
What's childish? Believing in God, not believing in God?
No, that he's forgotten about you. You know, I always find it amusing how human beings have such a simple perception of life and death, not to mention God.
Don't listen to this shit. He'll screw up your head beyond repair.
I mean, do you believe God floats around among the clouds with lightning bolts in hand, dispensing swift justice?
Hmm? Is this another one of your tests? Huh?
Huh?
Grapes?
Hmm?
What are you talking about? What does all this psycho babble have to do with me?
All right. Well, let's just say, just for argument's sake now, that this God, not the way you think of God, but this form of intelligence, were a scientist of sorts, right? And let's say that he has this laboratory, and it's big. I mean, very big. We're talking the size of the universe. You with me so far?
No.
Good. Now, our scientist sets out to gather empirical evidence about life. Hmm? All right. Now, it gets interesting. You know, you really should try some of this bread. It's got little nuts in it. All right. Now, he develops an ideal test environment like a petri dish. Except this petri dish is big. Say, the size of the Earth, perhaps? Hmm?
Why?
Now, that's a legitimate question. What if I told you that this God is conducting serious work? Like determining how he's going to populate the entire universe.
I'd say you're full of shit.
You find this a little difficult to accept, huh?
No. 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 No, no. It's perfectly level-headed and reasonable. Now, basically what you're saying is that we are nothing more than guinea pigs in some warped behavioral study.
Well, I wouldn't say warped, but I never thought of it that way.
Well, then what are you talking about? Huh? What does this have to do with anything? What does it have to do with me, with my sanity, with my being here? Hmm? Hmm?
Well, if it's not glaringly apparent, then I must have failed to do my job somewhere along the line here. How can I put this, Jason? It has to do with your life.
Life?
Life.
Life.
Life. heaven and hell. There must have been some significant moments in your life. God.
Death.
Anything come to mind?
This is bullshit.
I thought you said it was a plane.
I don't know who the fuck you are. I don't even know who the fuck I am.
This whole damn thing is nothing more than a dream.
So none of this is really happening.
You don't fucking exist.
Sounds like you're angry. You know, craziness is a relative concept.
God, please.
We're gonna get through this together.
Oh, God.
Anything that was a little dangerous or anything that was,
death-defying?
Well, I've always had this thing about dying young, and I really don't know why.
So how do you feel about death now?
Crash.
Excuse me.
Where the fuck am I? I want some fucking answers.
I mean, look at me. What's left of my life? Crash.
Excuse me. Do you believe in God? Don't ever touch the beard. You know, I always find it amusing how human beings have such a simple perception of life and death, not to mention God. I mean, you can't possibly think that life is fair. Not the way you think of God, but this form of intelligence. We're a scientist of sorts. And let's say he has this laboratory.
I haven't injected you with any drugs. And I couldn't care less about your silly phantom plane. I'm just trying to help you reconstruct your past.
That's what I'm here for.
I'd say you're full of shit.
Crash.
No, sir, we haven't found the other one yet.
And it's big.
Crash.
I understand, sir. Not a word.
We're talking the size of the universe.
Crash.
Definitely dead. Definitely dead.
Just can't be, no.
You just give it some time.
Time.
And I'm afraid ours is up. But Ms. Peters will validate you.
Be her.